The hitching post is waiting round the bend. My weary ride is coming to an end. Going to stop and wrap myself around the best rib tickling in this town, where laughing is in style. I think I'm gonna stop a while and smile. It's time for Cowboy Bob's Corral. Out where pal is a pal, we've got good times for you and lots of things to do. So come along, my cowboy buckaroo.
I was 27 years of age when I was offered the show, and the show has been off 27 years. So anyway, but it seems like yesterday.
Bob Glaze's career began as a studio tech at Channel 4, where he would later gain an unforgettable opportunity as Cowboy Bob.
I was just a cameraman working at Channel 4. I got to do camera on the Sammy Terry show, which is really fun. And I operated camera on Janie's show. Again, I'm sure you're not aware of her program. Your folks would be. And she was kind enough to let me be on her show a few times, playing guitar, singing. One thing led to another, and we recorded a Christmas album that is still relevant today.
Happy, joyful time of year. Snow is falling all around.
Glaze was offered the show and had to pick who and what he wanted to portray.
I said, I'm from Oklahoma, I know my way around a horse, and why not be a cowboy? And they said, okay, cowboy what? And I said, well, my dear mother named me Bob, so what's wrong with that? And we were on live at noon on Channel 4. We started January 7th, 1970. Then in the 80s, when you still weren't born, we were actually pre-taped, and it was on in the afternoon. But honestly, again, like I said earlier, I really, really enjoyed the live aspect in the 70s.
Oh, we also have a hand. Hey, I could always use a hand on this show. This is our friend Happy the Helping Hand. Nice to have you with us, my friend.
Oh, good to be
and,
here.
And, hey, you know, the Humane Society's been here since 1968, sheltered here. But
yeah.
You know something?
What?
They want to build a new shelter.
Oh, wow.
And we certainly encourage you to donate. They could use your help, okay?
Some of Bob's fans are now in their 40s, being young children at the time of the show.
I just remember that he played cartoons during his show, and that was probably the best part of it. That's about the only thing I remember about it.
Cowboy Bob's Corral involved numerous things, from introducing cartoons to bringing animals on the show.
I remember watching Cowboy Bob's Corral when I was about 5 or 6 years old. My sisters would leave for school, and I would go in my parents' bedroom and watch TV in there. Cowboy Bob was a host to cartoons. He would introduce Popeye and Tom and Jerry and different kinds of cartoons like that. He also had a dog named Tumbleweed, and I remember watching Tumbleweed. He would teach fire safety and how kids should stop, drop, and roll.
Hi, I'm Cowboy Bob, and this is Tumbleweed. Hey, you know how fires start? Well, careless smoking, faulty wiring, and playing with matches. But what do you do after tragedy strikes? If your clothes catch on fire, do what Tumbleweed's doing. Stop, drop, and roll.
But I learned early on that I absolutely love dogs. I love animals.
This love for animals stems from his sidekick from the show, Tumbleweed.
The T is in memory of my very, very first dog that I had on my TV show, and her name was, ask your parents, they'll know, Tumbleweed. And so this is Rocky T, a spiritual descendant of her. His mother's a black lab, and his daddy, we don't know, maybe a traveling carpet salesman from looking at his fur. And so a lot of the things we did on the show involved animals, not just domestic animals, but even wild animals. In fact, I never will forget Very seldom did I wear a bandana on the show, but thank goodness this one day I did, because he had a boa constrictor that was molting, you know what I mean? And when they molt, they don't see real well, because all their skin, including the skin on their eyeballs, is peeling off. And they, this snake, we were just about ready to come out live, okay? 5, 4, you know, they were counting down. The snake bit me, because he thought my hand was a gerbil, I guess, because he couldn't see real well. And, you know, 200 teeny tiny teeth marks bleed rather well. So I quickly grabbed the bandana, wrapped it around my hand, and we did the interview with the snake, and nobody ever knew the difference.
Bob also met his future wife while on set, which would change his life forever.
Well, I met her at Channel 4. Two of the greatest things I got out of my job at Channel 4 was a TV show and meeting the love of my life.
They trained me as a film editor, and I did that basically putting in commercial breaks into all the programs that they aired at that time. And because I was interested in the goings-on behind the scenes at a television station at noontime, instead of taking my lunch break out of the building, I would watch Cowboy Bob doing his Chuckwagon Theater program, and it was a lot of fun watching that program being done. And at that time, it was live television, so it was very, very unique. And next thing I knew, I got noticed, and Bob had the cameraman put the camera on me, and I could smile, and I ended up helping Cowboy Bob with the animals that he'd have on the show from the Humane Society, and just we just had fun.
In fact, I proposed marriage to her in 1975 while we were scuba diving in the Gulf of Mexico. And we were underwater, and when I did it.
Anyway, so he's pulling me down to an anchor on the sand channel, and all of a sudden he gets down on his knee, and he has a mesh bag, and he pulls out of his mesh bag a slate out, and on the slate is about this big. He has on the front side, "I love you very much, so here goes," and he flipped it over. "Will you marry me?" with 3 boxes, yes, no, or maybe. And I'm like, oh my gosh. And then as I'm savoring this moment, I look up at the surface, and everybody that was on the boat that wasn't a scuba diver had masks and snorkels, and they were watching from above this proposal to me at 30 feet below them. And I am just so excited. And of course, I had to think, okay, I can have some fun here. So I have the grease pencil, and he hands me a grease pencil to mark the appropriate box. And so I kind of thought about it, and then I took the pen and marked yes.
She accepted, and 40 years later, we're still hitched.
Gail recently retired from her career as a United Airlines pilot. Since then, the two have gotten more involved in their hobbies.
My wife Gail and I have been coming to the BBJY here in Martinsville since, the dark ages, 1978. And we probably have been members here longer than just about anybody. But we love it, and we love working out here.
I see Cowboy Bob occasionally around town. At the YMCA is where I've seen him the most. I think he goes there quite often. So when I see him, I nudge my husband and say, "Hey, you remember Cowboy Bob? I think that's him."
Locally, by the way, I still do personal appearances, and I still love it. I still, again, letting people know that Bob Glaze the name is Cowboy Bob, but I'm Bob Glaze, and I'm just a neighbor and a friend.
Echo the hoofs of history with sand the blow.
Here I am, just trying to make a buck, you know, trying to bring in some groceries. And people are actually tuning in to watch me do that. And I thought, boy, this is really wacky, but fun, wacky fun.
It's a lot of fun for me to watch both aspects of knowing Bob Glaze as my husband and friend to watching him being Cowboy Bob and entertaining people.